I just feel like painting black. Can I actually jump in here? Nope. Goosey! Yeah. I thought that was an enemy at first because I just see something orange like moving around down there, and then I get a closer look and I'm like, oh, that's the goose! Don't tell me I gotta go through this entire maze. Oh dear god, just spam it. Spam it all!
To be beautiful, and it was. It was not designed to be practical, and it wasn't. Whole families got lost for weeks at a time, mail took months to arrive, and many worried a labyrinth of this size was bound to attract dragons. Eventually, the complaints grew so loud, even the king couldn't ignore them.
You know, shit like this makes me think I'm gonna run into a dragon. Oh, that's a paintbrush. Thank you. How did I get up here? This game's kind of like a mindfuck.
The king was so frustrated with the messy, demanding people of his kingdom that he decided to start over. One morning he painted a boat and set off to find the perfect spot. He told himself he'd come back someday to finish what he had started, but of course, he never did.
Goose! And it flew away, you motherfucker. Oh, that doesn't count. There's a balloon hiding. Son of a bitch, there's a balloon hiding down there next to the freaking... That's actually pretty cool. I think it's even more amazing that you just walk through there and then magically you're fucking up all the way upstairs. I'm not complaining about it, it's just I think it's actually pretty cool.
For the first time in weeks, Monroe felt good. He felt even better when the wind pushed him close enough to reach the swan. He was feeling so good, in fact, that he forgot all about his fear of heights. But when the swan wriggled free and Monroe fell over the side, he remembered almost immediately. That might have been the end of Monroe, if this were a shorter story, but it isn't, which is why Monroe's troubles were just beginning.
Oh, boy.